When it comes to soccer, I'm not going to have a ton of knowledge of the sport, and I am going to butcher a ton of names. With that said, if you can stomach a new soccer fan doing his best to work his way through a stadium club Chrome box, you're going to enjoy today's video. Let's get into it. What's going on, YouTube? Run Good here, coming at you with a brand new product review, and I have been ripping just about every Champions League product that has came out this year, and this one is no exception. Today we have 2021-2022 Topps Stadium Club Chrome UEFA Champions League, and I'm excited. You guys know I am a casual soccer fan. I'm trying to learn it, both for the sake of the World Cup coming up just around the corner, and the fact that I am absolutely loving the quality of soccer cards. Let's be real. One of the key reasons that I continue to rip soccer is because the quality of the cards that gets printed in Italy for Topps significantly better than the quality of cards that we see here stateside, and I expect no different from this product.
Don't you go falling in love with it now.
If you are excited for today's video, as always, I do appreciate a like on my content. And if you're new here, and you are a massive soccer or football fan, and you are new here, and you can absolutely stomach the fact that I will butcher some names and not provide a ton of knowledge or insight as to the sport, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. That was a real good sell job. So again, this one came out last Wednesday, coming in at just under $200 a box. It's going to be Stadium Club Chrome with the full bleed photography. Stadium Club dating back to the early 90s with baseball. These cards are... you know, they're very, very good looking. That is one of the big appeals, is the photography. Stadium Club, always a photography-driven set. We are going to get one chrome autograph per box and some color as well. Let's go ahead and open the box on up, show you what's on the back, and there is not a ton. Not a ton. This is our latest top Champions League product. The most recent one prior to that was Finest, so we are getting... we're getting Champions League products faster than we're getting, again, there's not really much on the back because it's Topps, isn't there? We're getting far more soccer currently instead of baseball. Baseball kind of getting a lull, which kind of sucks. We're waiting for Topps Chrome. No clue if we're even going to see Stadium Club at whatever point. There was a rumor going around that for Stadium Club baseball, it might be suspended indefinitely this year. I don't know if that was a rumor or if that was fact, but I figured I'd mention it on the channel. We are going to get 18 packs per box. I believe 18, maybe 24. Yeah, 18 packs per box, 6 cards per pack. And putting it at 108 cards total per box. I already showed you that, so this is what I wanted to show you right there. If you want to pause the video and zoom in, there are the odds. My eyes are getting really, really bad as I get older, so it looks like I'm seeing autographed supers every one in every 158,000 packs or something like that. Yeah, my eyes are getting bad. I used to be able to read that text no problem, and man, I feel old right now.
I'm an old man, but crying out loud.
One auto per box. Let's go ahead and get into it. Again, my apologies if I butcher your favorite player's name or if I butcher all 6 names in the pack. Here we are, kicking things off with one I won't butcher, and that is Neymar. And again, photo-driven set. You're going to see full bleed photography. I like that for the PC. Little Neymar, little Ronaldo right after that. Only bangers here. Jack Grealish. We have Inori Pirlo. Again, my apologies. We have Tyler Morton. And man, I'm loving the look of this set. Christopher Nikon. I'm not even going to try. I'm so bad with some of these names. But again, the cards. Beautiful looking cards. And the quality of the cards is, I think, what draws me most to soccer right now. Because the feel of these cards, the way they feel, we just don't see this with normal Topps cards, normal Panini cards. I will say one thing that I'm noticing is, compared to the Chrome UEFA, which came out earlier this year, the cards are on a lighter stock. So it's not as thick as the stock from that set. We got Pedri right there. Seeing a... Phil Foden, that's going to be a real time. That's a pretty cool looking insert. Maybe we'll get real time with baseball later this year. Virgil van Dijk right there. That is Giovanni Reyna. Noticing, one thing that I'm noticing about some cards is players having their phones out. Players, that Neymar, he had his headphones on. his AirPod Maxes. Lewandowski right there with a bicycle kick. I believe that's a, is that called a bicycle kick in soccer? See, I don't know. Or is a bicycle kick what they do in Mortal Kombat? Dusan Lahovic. I'm seeing something here. Piscina. I like that. Glimpses of Gold. Jeremy Pino for Villarreal. That's a good looking insert too. Memphis Depay. Luis Muriel. And that is going to be Urien Timber for Ajax. Again, it's Stadium Club, so I think the value probably won't be there as much as Chrome or Finest, but if you like photography, this is the set. This is where all the photography is pretty much all on point. You don't get too many weird photos. You get a lot of, like, you know, team shots and things like that, or them entering the arena, cool stuff like that. Mohamed Salah right there, Xavi, Arnaut Danjuma for Villarreal. There's Leo right there. Just got my grade back on my Leo Messi auto from Obsidian, numbered 15, and it did come back in 9. I was really hoping I would gem that out. Vinny Jr. right there, and then Pedro Goncalves. I was really sad about that grade. It looked perfect when I pulled it, sent it to Hitman. Hitman said the same thing, and then PSA said, nope, that's a 9. Mason Mount, Noah Lang. We have Brendan Aronson on our auto, and that is going to be a orange auto, number 29 of 50, maybe a gold. I thought it was orange, but it looks like that one is actually gonna be gold. Midfielder for Salzburg, not somebody I'm super familiar with, but again, one of the trends that we are seeing with this set so far, a lot of phones in the pictures, and this one he's rocking, I believe those are gonna be Beats, not AirPods. Which is strange, you know. You'd like to see, you know, some of the ones of them entering is cool, but you know, if I was a huge fan of Aronson, this probably wouldn't be the auto I'd go after, you know, just kind of in street clothes, headphones, not even looking at the photo, you know. So as cool as some of the photography is, I really feel like on an auto, this one just doesn't sit right with me. It's just kind of weird. We have Paul Scholes on the base card, Alaba, and then also Karim Adeyemi for Salzburg. Still a lot of packs left. Hopefully we see some good color. And I did enjoy the inserts that we've seen so far. Junior Adamu for Salzburg. Frank Lampard for Chelsea. Federico Chiesa for Juventus. Aronson again for Salzburg. Pino for Villarreal. And Jules Cowan for Sevilla. Uh-oh, I'm seeing color in here. Maybe another insert. There's my dude Mukoko. Collect some of his stuff. Stanisic for Munich. That's cool. I'm curious what that's going to be, number 2. Benjamin Sesko for Salzburg is going to be not numbered. Interesting. I expected to see some numbering on a pink, but it almost looks like it could even be red. But I'm not seeing any numbering indicating anything super special on there. I was a little surprised by that. Josko Vardiol for Leipzig. Nuno Mendes is for PSG. And Trevor Chalaba. I'm sure I'm butchering just all kinds of names, so my apologies. I always apologize every time I do a soccer video, but yo, I'm trying my best. I'm trying to learn your sport. There's a lot to learn. There's a lot of leagues, and there's a lot of things that are much, much different about soccer than baseball, football, basketball here in the States. We have a wave of Bruno Fernandes. Gonna be numbered 146 of 150. Guess I'd say I'm probably a pretty casual PSG fan. Do kind of follow some of their stuff, their games, and what's going on with them. There's another one. Has another phone out. Sebastian Haller. And Locatelli. And KDB right there. But again, I do have some Mokokos in my PC. A couple from last year from Merlin. A couple of his rookies. Big fan of Leo. Goncalves, like I said, I'm such a casual. Probably pissing off a lot of people right now. Championship contributions, that's Vinny Jr. for Real Madrid. That is an amazing looking insert. That is an amazing looking insert. This looks like you could put this on a thick card and put it in a more premium Topps product. I don't even know. Something like don't even know. This kind of looks almost like tier one or something like that. I know Bundesliga tier one recently came out. Definitely put it in a more high end product than put that design in a more high end product than Stadium Club. Kai Havertz, Kenneth Taylor, and also Alessandro Bastoni. Jonathan David, Phil Foden. We have a real time of Raheem Sterling. Donnarumma, Susik, and then also Sabetchu. I will say, you know what, we do a soccer break or two every week, for those wondering. No soccer breaks this week. Me and the wifey do have a little bit of time off. So I am pre-recording some of the content this week. Actually recorded this one last Friday, just the way our schedule is looking. So no breaks this week, but we will probably have this product in Finest and maybe even Sapphire. Still have a few of those boxes. And a break probably next week. Let's get this one right. Mambimbi. We have I like that one. We have a refractor of Javi, one of the most coveted rookies of this class. I will definitely take that and top load it on up. Feel pretty lucky. I love that photo too. Feel pretty lucky to pack that one. So I'm hearing I've been watching a lot of soccer videos lately. One of the things that our international collector friends like to say is, you know, you pack that card. That's something that we don't really say, Anthony Alonso right there. Something you don't really hear too many breakers or too many people over here stateside say, you know, I packed that card. And by packed it, you mean, you know, you got that card out of a pack. It's interesting, the lingo, you know, when you're watching, you know, people in, I think I've watched, you know, a couple Australians rip soccer. I've watched plenty of people over in the UK rip it. And I hear that quite a bit. I packed that card. Miguel Gutierrez, rookie right there. Azela Zuz. I'm not even going to try. Manuel Neuer right there. And Harvey Elliott. I like that. That's a cool photo. That is a very cool photo. So again, Stadium Club is for you. If you enjoy the look of these cards, if you enjoy the full bleed photography, definitely a set for you. I would say you're probably going to get more value out of Chrome UEFA. Maybe even Finest, but if you like the look of these cards, definitely this set for you. Joe Felix right there on the real time. Kareem Adeyemi right there. I'm going to try that one again. And another Manuel Neuer. Collation issues. Seeing the same collation in the last couple of packs. Cole Palmer. We have a Joe Felix refractor. Like that. Glimpse of gold, Eric Garcia, kind of a troll's gold on that one, because every time you see it, the edge, you think you hit a gold. Yeah, we're seeing some of the same cards. There we go, Kylian Mbappe for the PC, going in straight to my PC, and Weston McKennie as well. Four packs left today. I want to thank you for joining me. You could be watching other people who are very knowledgeable about the sport, but you chose to watch my video, and I appreciate y'all very, very much for that. Kamavinga right there. Romario. Try not to have these fall over. Beam Team. I was wondering if Beam Team is going to be in a long-standing insert in the Stadium Club line. Beam Team going to be Pedri. I imagine these are probably one per box. We see one to two per box with Stadium Club Chrome Baseball. I would expect that to not be super rare. Decatlier right there. Alfonso Davies. And Antonio Griezmann. Mbimbi right there. Landrup. Gonna be Zobisli. Tenali, Jadon Sancho, and then Roberto Carlos. We pulled an auto of him out of Finest in our last soccer break. Couple packs left here in the box. I'm liking what I'm seeing. The price point's probably fine. Might be a little too expensive. You know, $125, $150. I think these boxes would be a little bit more appropriately priced. But there we go. Gravenberch for Ajax, and that is going to be a refractor. And I think we might have another numbered underneath it. Yeah, refractor right there. And then we have a green, and that is going to be Arnaut Danjuma for Villarreal. Going to be numbered 198 of 199. And it has kind of an interesting pattern to it. I noticed that. It's almost like I'm not quite sure what the name of the parallel is. I probably should have did a little research. Come a little more prepared, but soccer typically does tend to have some unique parallels compared to baseball. Kind of got that, you know, I don't know, glass break kind of parallel, him kind of jumping off the card. It's kind of cool. kind of cool. We need more of that. Need more parallels other than just standard color. We need cool effects like that. I like that. Sesko right there. Trezeguet and Schmeichel. I pulled a Gravenberg auto for myself out of Chrome earlier this year. That video is on the channel. I think that was an auto to 52. Final pack of the day. Do we have anything left in the box? There is Erling Haaland right there. Pulisic, we got a couple back-to-back championship cards, or back-to-back trophy cards, that's cool. Kalulu, Cellini, Musiala, and then we're going to end today with Iniesta for Barcelona. But yeah, you know what? I like the product. Full bleed photography, looking sharp. Otto, I wasn't really sold on. I don't know too much about the player myself, I will say that right now. But this time, this is one of the cards where I think that the photography does miss the mark. Maybe when they have kind of a picture like this, you find a different picture to go with the, to go instead of just using the base photo. Cause this one, I don't know who would want this card, I guess. If I was a player collector, probably look for something, you know, an action shot or something like that. I don't know who this card appeals to. This one definitely appeals to me, the Javi rookie refractor. And then just some other okay stuff today, Gravenbach. Danjuma to 199, the Beam Team Pedri, very cool. Joao Felix refractor, Kylian Mbappe for the PC, Vinny Jr., that card looks great. Bruno Fernandes on the wave, and then Sesko again on the same pattern, now that I'm noticing it, same pattern on the back there. I thought that one would probably be numbered. Looks like it could have been a red or a pink, but non-numbered on that one as well. Overall, my thoughts from somebody who doesn't know a lot about soccer cards, but is doing his best to learn. I like the product. I think it could be a hair cheaper. But when you're opening products like soccer, like wrestling, and some of the non-baseball, football, basketball products, these products have not, you know, gone to $600 like we see with like Optic Basketball, for example, or Select Football, for example. Those products, it seems like it's almost impossible to get your money back. Whereas on a bad box like this, maybe we still have 40, 50 bucks worth of cards there. You know, that's not 200. Let's be real. That's not 200. But it's also not as bad of a feel bad as opening a $1,600 box and only getting, you know, 100 back or 200 back. So I do think that there is a lot of value with soccer, even with baseball. You know, the prices haven't gotten crazy yet. And definitely with wrestling, you know, I've done a wrestling member exclusive video yesterday. If you're not a member, you can join the channel and check that out. Any of the tiers give you access to the member exclusive videos. That is going to do it for me today. As the World Cup approaches, we will continue to rip more soccer. Maybe I'll get up out of my comfort zone and do some Bundesliga for y'all, or some non-Champions League. Champions League is the one that I seem to know the best, but maybe I'll get out of my comfort zone next time. That is going to do it for me today. Take care, stay safe, and we'll catch you next time on Down the Road.